I just wanted you to watch me dissolve slowly in a pool of love, your love.
When you risk like this, you don't check the forecast, every day it's gonna rain. Yeah, made a brick do a brick, I ain't whip up shit, this pure cocaine. Yeah, from the streets, but I got a little sense, but I had to go coop no brain. Coop no brain, I ain't worried about you, I'ma do what I do, and I do my thing. Bought a brand new shoe, told her, kick rocks, don't stand too close. Diamonds, kick box, ain't red, me and gold, so I don't stop. I know they wish they can catch me, but keep wishing. You think I done turned into a fiend for these bitches? Tryna stuff as much as I can, and these bitches major bitch fuck on my fan. There's no difference, I ain't never pop no Xan. I sip scissor, if I ever have to turn on the gang, I won't do it. If I put it on a song, I send it to Ben through. I can't put it in my song, I know how to feel old. Scream free out of the house, but I ain't no fam gon'. Gave my mama 10 bands, sent me to Cancun. Got a crowd going dumb, but I ain't no damn fool. If I went in there and did it, then maybe you can too. We done came a long way from broken shoes. When you risk like this, you don't check the forecast, every day it's gon' rain. Yeah, made a brick do a brick, gang whip up shit, this pure cocaine. Yeah, from the streets, but I got a little sense, but I had to go coop no brain. Coop no brain, I ain't worried about you, I'ma do what I do, and I do my thing. When you risk like this, you don't check the forecast, every day it's gon' rain. Yeah, made a brick do a brick, gang whip up shit, this pure cocaine. Yeah, from the streets, but I got a little sense, but I had to go coop no brain. Coop no brain, I ain't worried about you, I'ma do what I do, and I do my thing. Do my thing. Got $250,000 in a book bag, new era, I'm a dope boy, no care. I'm living my best life for real, just love the dealership, no tag. If we opposite, it won't work, it won't last, be the opposite, knocked off, toe tag. I ain't been home in a month, got my whole mad. They need me in the trap, but I can't go back. I jumped out the port with $100 slab. I got M's in the bank, give a damn what they think. Everybody I ever shot my shot at, called it. Everything you ever see me riding, bought it. Big dog status, I ain't gotta sell drugs. Put my craft in the rap, then I took off, yeah. New G-Wagon, no key, this a push start. I can hit the gas, make it disappear. When you risk like this, you don't check the forecast. Every day it's gon' rain, yeah. Made a brick do a brick, gang whip up shit, this pure cocaine. Yeah, from the streets, but I got a little sense, but I had to go coop no brain. Coop no brain, I ain't worried about you, I'ma do what I do, and I do my thing. Do my thing. When you risk like this, you don't check the forecast, every day it's gon' rain. Yeah, made a brick do a brick, gang whip up shit, this pure cocaine. Yeah, from the streets, but I got a little sense, but I had to go coop no brain. Coop no brain, I ain't worried about you, I'ma do what I do, and I do my thing. Do my thing.
What it do, YouTube? My name is Bear Witness. Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about Apex Legends, and specifically, we're going to be talking about the best controller settings or best console settings for you guys, so you guys can get more wins and things like that. Now, what I do want to tell you guys is if you guys are new to the channel, make sure you guys click that like button and click that sub button if you enjoy the content. But with all that being said, we're going to hop right into it. Now, it's officially been 12 days since release of Apex Legends. I've been grinding this game a lot. I've been playing it a lot, and I have gotten tons, and I mean tons of wins, crazy amount of wins. I think right now I'm at 70 plus wins. So I've been grinding. I've been trying to get my best settings out there. I have been tweaking them, lowering them, raising them, messing with some weird settings, and trying to see what was the best thing. What I saw actually helps my game excel. What I get top kills with, you know, things like that, things that I excel with, and things like that. So what I am going to tell you guys is just like any of my other settings videos, this will not make you instantly amazing at the game, but what it will hopefully do is help you guys out in a more broad sense. So you guys can have fun playing the game, and so you guys can enjoy everything about, you know, getting those dubs, getting those champion screens, whatever you guys want to call it. But with all that being said, we're going to hop right into the settings. And right now we're going to start off at the very top. One of the key things that I believe helps me out in this game is the evolved controller preset. Now, this is a little bit different, and it'll be very difficult if you guys are not privy to the whole system, if you guys have been playing on default for a while. But the evolved playlist is probably my favorite playlist because it allows me to crouch with my right stick, but it also allows me to not have to use my buttons. Now, I play with a cinch controller. I enjoy using it when I do play with it, but for the most part, I think about things on the other side of things where people are not like that. They don't have, you know, extra paddles or extra buttons in the back, so they don't actually have the ability to jump without, you know, taking their hand off the thumbstick. With this, you don't need a scuff, you don't need anything. You can jump with your L1 button, and it is nasty. Like, it is the best thing that I have seen from a controller preset since Bumper Jumper, which is also in the game, But the only thing that doesn't, that Bumper Jumper doesn't have, is it doesn't have the crouch with the right stick, and that's something that I enjoy as well. So Evolved is the one I play with mostly, and it's not too much of a difference except for your abilities. You use your tactical ability with X, and to use your ult, you need to press X and R1 at the same time. Now, this, like I said, takes a little bit of getting used to, especially if you guys have been playing on a different preset, but if you guys have already been playing on this preset, this is nothing new, so yeah. So, we have tap to reload, we have the stick layout set on default, we have toggle crouch button, and we have hold for the A button, not toggle. All of that stuff is pretty standard. I don't think I have to go into any explanation with all of that, guys, but if you guys want to know anything, you guys can communicate with me in my comment section, so make sure you guys are hitting me up there if you guys have any questions. Now, sensitivities. Sensitivity, I tweaked with a lot. I played on 4, I played on 5, played on 6, played on max. The thing that I noticed is that my shotgun shot, which is the shotgun, is a very key part of my loadout most of the time, and most of my, you know, hip firing is geared around 5. Like, it's perfect, it's not too slow, it's not too fast, it allows me to have quick reactions, and I'm able to do quite a bit with it without feeling like I'm overwhelmed with the speed of the game, because the game does get fast at a certain point in time, and having a high sensitivity does not help with that. So I play on 5, which the game says it's very high. I personally don't think so, but there's that. But if you guys want a little bit of a tweak there, I have something for you guys if that's too low. Now, with sensitivity ADS, I personally love staying on default. I tried using a lot of different things. I noticed that my aim was really, really weird in certain situations. Like, it keeps the defaults on this game is probably the perfect I've ever played, the most perfect I've ever played inside of an FPS when it comes to ADS. It keeps it tight without keeping it too tight. It's very, very useful, and I'm very, very happy with it, and I probably won't be changing it unless they actually add changes like Fortnite did. You know, aside from this, this should keep you through to the rest of the game. I don't think they'll be making that many tweaks to the sensitivities, but if they do, you know, I'll be, you know, making another video revising this and trying to tell you guys the next set of best settings. Now, back to sensitivity. If you guys want a little bit more of a curve, like, or a little bit more of an edge, you guys can use the response curve. Now, the response curve goes like this. When I was using 5, when I wanted a little bit of a boost, which I just normally play on Classic, I like it, but when I felt like I wanted a bit of boost, fine aim was very, very good. It made it so not all of my movements were super big. It was small, and they were tiny, tiny adjustments that were made. I think this one's probably the best one if you guys are gonna change your response curve. I don't recommend it. It's not that great, and it'll usually leave you guys in a really weird state of play. Like, I almost guarantee you that if this is not important, unless you guys are one of those people that play on max sensitivity and it's still not high enough, then you guys can go switch over to high velocity and probably turn shit up, you know, if you guys are trick shotters or something like that. You know, it's crazy, you know, you thought you'd see Fortnite trick shotters, but they're there, they're out there. Now, look dead zone and movement dead zone, those are all on small, the least amount of drift that we could possibly have. Inverted look off, vibration off. I personally don't like vibration. I feel like the vibration messes with your aim because you concentrate on the vibration instead of concentrating on the game. That's just me. It could possibly be a superstition, but yeah, not saying that you guys should actually do that, but that's just me, like I said. Now, last thing I'm gonna talk to you guys about in this general thing is field of view. I cannot play this game on anything lower than 110. So, what I will tell you is that if you guys follow my move, follow my wave on this, and go to 110, it does, for me, I find the game more enjoyable like this. I don't know if it improves your performance. I feel like it does improve my performance, but I don't know if it improves your performance. Also, I want to tell you guys that on PlayStation, I've noticed that while having my field of vision on 110, the likelihood of my game crashing has gotten higher. They're trying to fix that, they're talking about fixing that, but yeah, but most of my games, I have a lot of fun using this at max, and I personally, after a long time of using it, cannot use it anything else. It makes my gun feel too close to the screen, it makes me feel like I'm in a box, and I completely just can't have fun like that. what I can say is that it doesn't necessarily hinder your gameplay. I definitely recommend giving it a try for a couple of games. If you don't like it, you can always bring it back down. But this is probably one of the best things that I think that they've done in the game, especially for console players. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully it helps you guys get a lot of more of those championships. And if it does, you guys know I always appreciate you guys coming back and tell me if these settings work for you. But with that being said, guys, I hope you guys have a nice, wonderful rest of your day. And I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out of here. Peace.